Hey, what's up guys? In this video, I'm gonna show you how to add simple rotational components to any mesh or actor that you might want, and that will cause it to perpetually rotate on any axis that you want continuously forever. So in my content drawer here, I have this SM rotating obstacle, and I can just drag it into the level like this, and in order for it to rotate, we need to add the components that I mentioned. So click on add and search for a rotating movement. With that selected, then we can change some settings. So we have the rotation rate. This is basically how fast it's gonna rotate on any axis. And if it's set to zero, it's not gonna rotate on that axis. And then we have also the pivot transition and bunch of other settings. Generally, just you're gonna be messing around with these three though. One thing to note, if I'm gonna go into the play, as you can see, it's not moving at all. And the reason for that is when we leave the play, we have this mobility of, and then it's the name of the mesh and the path to it, it's not set to movable. So how do we set it to movable? Well, it's really simple. Just go into your level, select that mesh, and then under the mobility in the transform, we have static, stationary, and movable. So we're gonna just swap it to movable, hit play, and as you can see, we are rotating as we want to. One thing that we can do here is press F8, and then we can just select the mesh, and then we can change the settings under the rotating movement. So select the component, and now we can mess around with the settings. So for example, instead of 180, I can set it to 0, which will stop the movement, but I can also send it to, let's say, 500. As you can see, it's gonna rotate much faster. And then we can just add another rotations as well. So we can have these kinds of continuous rotations that are on any axis that you want, or on multiple of them. The next thing that I want to show you is that we can not only apply this to static meshes that are actually in the level, we can also apply it to actors. So in here I have BP obstacle actor that just has that same static mesh inside it. Click on that and search for a rotating movement. Then we have all the exact same settings that we had on the previous attempt. So we have the rotation rate, pivot translation, etc. And we can set it as well. Another thing here to note is if I'm gonna select the static mesh and then duplicate it and move the other one above here. If I go and compile this and place the actor in the level and hit play, as you can see, they are gonna move both at the same time. But what if you want only one static mesh to? Well, what we can do is we can go into the event graph, get, let's say, the event begin play, get a rotating movement component, and we can drag from it and search for set updated component. And we can plug that into begin play. And in here, we are gonna just plug in whatever component of that actor we want to rotate. So let's say that I want this bottom one to be static, but I want this top one to rotate. So I'm just gonna get that static one and then plug it into the new updated component. Only the one that we updated is now rotating. So I hope you found this helpful. If you did, leave a like and subscribe. It helps out a lot. Thanks for watching and see you in the next one. Bye!